Good day, students. How are we doing? I hope we are okay. Today we are going to be looking at cosine and sine. This is what we have as the first topic in our scheme, cosine and sine. I think we'll start with the first one, cosine rule. Cosine rule is a rule that is used in solving problems of triangles that are not right angle. If you have a triangle that is not right angle, that's where we use the cosine rule. Now, what is this cosine rule all about? Cosine rule is saying that if you have a side C in a triangle, it is equal to A squared, which is on the other side, plus B squared minus 2AB cos C. This big C is the angle. So this is the cosine rule or the cosine formula. So in the course of our discussion today, we are going to be looking at how to create this formula or how this formula was gotten, meaning we are going to prove it. We're going to prove this formula. So what do we do if we want to prove this? Because I've said this formula is used in solving triangles, I will first of all start by drawing a triangle that is not right angle. If you look at this triangle is never a right angle triangle. I'm sure we still remember a right angle triangle. A right angle triangle is a triangle that looks like this. Then here you see the right angle, meaning that angle there is 90. So this is a right angle triangle. So now, if we are to use this cosine rule, the triangle we are dealing with, it should be something like this, or something like this. That's the kind of triangle we are dealing with. So you either have something like this, or something like this, this or this. Now, in the case of this one is an acute angle. Why this one is an obtuse angle? The obtuse angle is here. Here, the acute angle should be here. Now, you know what? Yes, this angle here is obtuse. Why this one is acute? What is an acute angle? An acute angle is an angle that is less than 90. An obtuse angle that is greater than 90. So, cosine rule helps us to solve problems of angles that are less than 90 degrees in a triangle, or angles that are greater than 90 degrees in what a triangle. So proof, if we are given something like this and they are asking us to construct or derive the cosine rule, the first thing you do is to label it. Label the triangle. You can label it B, C, A or A, C, B, A, B, C. Then produce a line that will run from here to here. This line you have produced, you call it the height of the triangle. Then call this place N. N is the length from B to C, the division of this line. So if here the total length is A, total length is A, meaning here will be what? A minus X, and here will be X. When you add these two, you get A. Then here is C. Why is here C? Now, for a triangle, I want us to know this now. For a triangle, anytime you are given a triangle, all these parts, this point here, is where the angle is. And the side that is directly opposite the angle is represented with a small letter of the angle. So writing C here is because this angle here is the big angle C. Then this side, the small C, is representing the side. So here we're having B, meaning here I'll write small b. So here is A, meaning that's the length from here to here. Here, length from here to here is A, that is A. So get it. Is like this. Now, if we are to prove it, We have to prove that C squared is equal to A squared plus B squared minus 2A B cos C. Look at the C I wrote now. This C is this C here. That's the angle. Why this first C is for the side? That's this one here. So, what do we do to prove this? In order to prove this, the first thing you do is to consider this part as a right angle triangle. Look at it. If you look at this shape, generally we have two right angle triangles. One is facing this side, the other one is facing the other. So if you consider this as a right angle triangle, as considering triangle A, B, N as this one, using Pythagoras theorem, we have this side, which is the longest side, the square of the longest side from Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem says the square of the longest side or the square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the square of the other side. So if this one is the longest side, so the square, which is C squared, is equal to, let's represent this side, because this side is the height, let's represent it with H. So the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the square of the other side, the sum of the square of the other side, meaning A minus X squared plus H squared. A square of this side plus square of this side, which is H squared. That's from the theory. So if I'm to go by this, C becomes C squared will now be, open up this, we'll be having A minus X, another A minus X. Why are we having this? Because it says square plus H squared. Now if you open up this, you have A times A will give you A squared. Then A times minus X will give you minus AX. Then this one also. Minus X times A will give you minus AX. Know the reason why I'm bringing A first. A alphabetically comes first. So, S times X is what? X squared. Minus times minus will be plus. Plus X squared. Then plus H squared. This is what you have. Now, if you look at this and this, they are lighted, they are carrying AA. So you collect them together or you group them. Minus AS minus AS will give you minus 2AS. So from here, C squared is now equal to A squared minus 2AX. That's the addition of this one and this one. Then plus S squared plus H squared. This is where we are now. Now, what do we do? You can also remember this. This one is X squared plus H squared. If I'm to go by this other part of the shape, the triangle, that is considering triangle A N C or A C N. Let me write it here. Considering triangle ACN, that's angle C. You will notice that we have another right angle triangle. Now, following the same Pythagoras theorem, here it will now be B squared, which is the hypotenuse, is equal to the square of the other, the sum of the square of this side and this side. B squared will now be S squared plus H squared. Now, the reason why I underline this is because we are having similar thing here. Meaning, if this one is S squared plus A squared, and S squared plus A squared is equal to B, I can replace it with B squared here. So if I do that, if I replace this S squared plus H squared with B, I will now have C squared is equal to a squared minus 2ax plus b squared, because everything here has been replaced with what? B squared. So what do we now have? We are having this. Now c, small letter c, take note, this one is small letter c, squared is equal to a squared, I want to bring these ones to one side, plus b squared minus 2ax. That's what you have. Now, considering this, so like I said, c squared will not be equal to a squared plus b squared minus 2ax. Now, x, from here, if we are to consider this again, then using the trigonometric ratio, have to consider this angle C using trigonometric ratio, that is considering in triangle ACN. Considering angle C, which of the relationship connects this angle with this side and this side? Sorry, with this side and this side. We have SOCATOA, which is so for sine, cam for cos, and toa for tan. So is opposite to hypotenuse, ca is what? Adjacent to hypotenuse, and toa is opposite to what? Adjacent. Now, the one that connects the hypotenuse and the adjacent to this angle is ca, cos. So cos C, as this C, will now be equal to what? Adjacent, where is the adjacent? X over the hypotenuse, which is what? B. So if you make X the subject here by cross multiplying, we now have X will now be equal to, this will multiply this, this will multiply this, that, like this, and like this. That's 1 times X is giving you X, then B times cos C will give you B cos C. Take note, this C is capital letter. Now we know what S is. You notice I also underlined it. Anywhere I see S, I will replace it with B cos C. If I do that, I will now have C squared, small letter C, this one is small letter C, will now be equal to A squared plus B squared minus 2A, then anytime you see X, replace it with this, you now have B cos capital letter C. We have succeeded in proving the rule or the law or the formula. Remember, I gave us this C squared A squared B squared minus 2AB cos C. You look at it here, we have succeeded in proving it. C squared cos A squared plus B squared minus 2AB. Cos C. That's the proof. So I've succeeded in proving it. This is the proof. Now, this one, this formula is specifically for the angle C, the side C. That's for this one. What about the side A and B? It follows the same pattern. So for B, B will now be B squared, A squared, then plus C squared. Take note to look at the pattern here. C is equal to AB. You will notice that everything here, everything that occur here is A and B. Then the angle is C. So if you change the side to B, meaning everything that you see around this place will be what? A and C. So A squared plus C squared minus 2AC. Are you seeing it? Then cos, take note, the small letter here is C. And the big letter here is C. So the small letter here is B, meaning the big letter here should be what? B. That's for the second one. Then lastly, which is the third one, you know a triangle has three sides. So for the third one, A squared will now be what? Following the same pattern. B squared plus C squared minus 2 BC cos A. That's if I'm looking for the side A. So with these three formulas, we can solve any problem on the side of what? A triangle in which the triangle is not what? A right angle triangle. This is the formula that we used to get the side. The formula that we can also use to get the angle will be discussed later. As for each angles, we can also create a formula from here. It's very easy. All you need to do is to mix subject formula. That's all. It's very easy. We'll discuss that one later. Now, continuing. After knowing this, I just discuss why we need this. One, we need this formula to solve triangles that are not right angle triangles. Now, the second thing, reason why we need this formula is it enables us to solve triangle in which two sides and the included angle is given. How? If we have a triangle like this, this is a triangle, and you are given this side, let's say here is 5 cm, here is 4 cm, and there's an angle here, 60 degrees. This side and this side, they are connected to this angle. So because they are connected to this angle, we call it the included angle. So anytime you have a triangle that looks like this, two sides and the included angle is given. That's when you use this formula. Or that's where it finds its application. So anytime you see any shape in which two sides, this one is one side, this one is one side, and they are connected by an angle here, use the formula. Now, if you are given something like this, let's say you have a triangle like this, in which this side is given, let's say here is 10 cm, here is 5 cm, and they gave you an angle here, you cannot use this formula. You cannot use the cosine formula. Because the side is not connected to the other side by an angle. So you cannot use the cosine formula. That is where the sine rule comes in. We'll be looking at that maybe later. So take note. It's only when the sides are connected, let's say here is 15 cm, something like this, you can use any of this formula we just derived. Can we see an example, just one example before we go? So for example number one. Find AB. We have the shape. This is not a right angle triangle. They said here is SCM, here is B, here is A, here is C, and here is 3 cm, here is 2 cm. They gave us the angle here as 80 degrees. Now, if you look at this, this one is an example of the case I just discussed. We can only use the law or the cosine rule when we have something like this. This side is given, this side is given, and the angle that connects them called the included angle. So we can use cosine rule. What are we looking for? We are looking for this side. The name of this side is called S. So invariably, from all the solving I've done, this side or this angle is angle C, meaning this side there will be side C. So what it means is that in order to use the formula, I need to use the first one, that's this one. This one will help me in solving it. So from cosine rule, we have C squared is equal to A squared plus B squared minus 2AB cos C. Now in this case, C is X, so I will replace this C squared with X. So S squared is now equal to A. What is A? A is 3. Take note. 3 squared plus B is 2. 2 squared minus 2 times 3. Sorry, times 2. A is 3. 3 times 2. Cos the angle, which is 80. Now, if you solve, you have 3 squared is what? 9 plus 4 minus 12. Because 2 times 3 is 6, 6 times 2 is 12, of course 80. Now what do you add? 13 minus 12 cos 80 is equal to s squared. Now then you'll be having 13 minus 12 times 0.1736. You check your four figure table, or you can also use calculator to check this. Now 13 minus, if you multiply these two, you'll be having, if you multiply this, then you subtract this, you'll be having 10.92. That's what you'll be having. At the end, they're asking us to get x, that's this time x. But we have something like this, x squared is equal to 10.92, meaning this square will have to go. If a square crosses the equality sign, it changes to square root. So x becomes square root of 10.92. Look for the square root of 10.92. You have it as 3.305 centimeter. Or if you want to give an approximate answer, that is symbol for approximation, 3.3. As the approximate answer. So, CM. We stop here for today. In our next class, we continue from here. Meanwhile, if you have any question on this, try and relate it to me via our WhatsApp group. Thank you very much.